Hello everyone, and welcome back to Settlements and Survival and Spectacle Island. Today we're going to do, we're going to build another building here. We're going to build a doctor's hut, office, shack, whatever. But first, let's go ahead and go over the changes from last time, the previously seen on. So of course, I had that rickety guard tower, so I redid it. Now it looks like this. I kind of pushed it out, pushed it over a little bit, so it would have a sort of a gate entrance with the other guard station that I built. We'll go up in here really quick and take a look, but it's the normal, you know, yeah, this is pretty much a standard. I mean, a little extra stuff, but not much. And then here, there's no changes in here, just a mattress on the floor and the guard there. We'll give her some fittings and accoutrement later. The fence, of course, had to extend the fence a little bit to get to the new guard tower, stuck the turret up on top of the post and the rubber shack junk wall, add another settler, added some more crops, have a little tree-lined pathway here in the middle going down to this gate, which I changed my mind on having because I don't think I'm going to go to the water like I thought I was going to when I started. So I basically blocked this off. But yeah, a little nice tree-lined walkway, and then there's their little rest area. A nice tidy break area for them out in the middle with some snacks and drugs and whatever, some crap I scavenged from over there. No changes over here, although I think for the next one I'm going to put another house over there outside what the wall would have been to block it off. And then we got our doctor. She's waiting patiently for her house. And her house is going to go right here on this little thing. Basically, I'm going to use it to cordon off this area. We'll junk fence it on the outside and go from there. So what are we going to use for her house as the model? What we're going to use is this. You've seen this house probably 100 times. We are at, of course, Bunker Hill. This is Kessler's house. And this is a fairly complicated, very mod piece heavy item. Like down on the bottom, like here on the side, we've got a blank wall, and down there you've got the green walls, and there's all kinds of stuff stuck under the bottom there, a little bunch of half walls. And then there's a cow in the way, so let's jump over the cow. Underneath there's that half wall again with the white stripe on it. And of course the bed sheet, deep shack wall, balcony thing. Now she's got like a porch here with a ladder, shack supports, which I don't have, but standard floor pieces, standard railings, nothing really major here, right? The half wall from USO or mods that we don't have in vanilla, the house with the broken corner out of it, the roof, sorry. And of course, standard floor, some plywood, another half wall. And then this one, we've got this one on our standard thing with the snap-in wall. And then this piece right here, I don't have. That's a modded piece. Now there's a huge gap here where they've angled the flat roof up. So her house already has holes in it, but the whole back wall here is all modded pieces, right? All extra pieces with the shack walls and stuff, two floor pieces, and then there's the deep balcony thing. Now the tricky parts about this is you can see they haven't used the snap-in wall here on this deep wall. They sort of jammed a half wall underneath that foundation. That will come into play later because I forgot how that's set up. And then there's some cement blocks that are blocking off the gap. Of course, the stairway with the raised shack floor here, right? But this is a fairly basic, fairly straightforward thing with a lot of modded pieces on it and some angled trickery that we're going to have to compensate for because we are building with vanilla pieces. So this is what we're going to build. This is our template model. How I'm going to build it is I'm going to take it, since it's basically two pieces, right? The elevated like foyer, the single piece with the extra stuff in the patio, and then there's the double piece in the back that's lower. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna build this in two sections, group select them together, and then lift the whole thing up and place it. That's the theory. Doesn't quite work like that. We're gonna see why in a minute. So first off, I'm gonna start building from the patio, because when I do this kind of stuff, right, when I have lower pieces like this, I always like to build down from roofs, but up from floors, because it's easier for me to manage this sort of thing. So I put put the patio up, put the walls in, substitute where I can, and just basically finish this out as best I can from memory with, you know, the obvious substitution. So while this is going on, I had a recent scare with my game the other day when I went to save. It saved, and when it went to exit the game, it said, sorry, you're out of space. We can't save this game. And I'm like, okay. They're all, you know, delete old save games or whatever. I'm like, fine, whatever. So I get out of the game, I go back in, and my menu is green. It's not aqua. And I'm like, okay, this is a problem. What's going on? I can't load games. I can't do anything. I'm like, what the hell? I mean, I would love to delete my save games, but I can't. There's no way to get into that. So I'm looking online for this error, and apparently it's a fairly common thing. It turns out, I think, from what I was able to understand on the reading part, is that the 2 gig, you know, reserve file, that's your save games too. So when that gets full, you can't save your game, and you have to delete old games. But if you're over your capacity, you can't load the game to get back in and do your save. So I'm like, what the hell am I going to do? I'm stuck. I'm, you know, of course, now I'm freaking out. I'm like, okay, I've lost everything. I've literally lost all my saves on everything and whatever. So after about, I don't know, 45 minutes, an hour of trying things, panicking things, ending up deleting my mods again on accident or purpose, I can't figure out which, because the Xbox One does not give you a file directory. I can't just go in there and look inside these files to see what the hell they're made of. So what ended up happening is I had to go into my like game management, and there's an option where you can clear your save games, right? So what you do, the process here, if this happens to you, is you go in, you clear your save games, you log out, close it out, shut down, start it back up, log back in. So when you connect to Xbox Live the next time, it syncs with the cloud and all your saves are apparently there as well. And then it just re-downloads all your saves. And in my case, I lost about, I don't know, an hour and a half, 2 hours, which is not bad. I mean, I've lost more on forgetting to save in survival. So moral of the story, clean out your saves. If you're a re-rollaholic, an altaholic like I am, and you've got 65 characters with 23 saves apiece, yeah, you do make a point to go through every now and then and delete all but maybe 3 saves. Now, if you play mostly survival, it's not a problem because, of course, survival only saves 3 games anyway, so that's not too bad. But I had a bunch of normal mode characters from back in the day, and I was just saving like crazy. So, keep that in mind. If you haven't done save game maintenance in a while, it might not be a bad idea to just take a look, go through all your characters, especially if you have a lot of characters with a lot of saves, and like clean them out. So you don't have a heart attack like I did thinking, oh my God, I just lost a couple thousand hours of save games and builds and blah, blah, blah. I mean, I was all set to go, you know what? Hell with it, I'll just make a video and we'll re-roll and I'll just start over again, I guess. So, okay. So now we've got most of the building, right? We substituted the half wall with that, you know, that 3-stack wall with the railings. And now I'm just gonna stick another wall in the back to complete the ensemble here. So yeah. That's what's going on there. And of course, I've been playing the hell out of immersive gameplay and doing builds. Mostly small things, very, very small things, like the 10 pines thing. That is turning out to be what most of my builds in this mod are going to be. I've got one planned to show y'all what I'm calling a micro build, which is basically the outpost for the player, right? Which is my depot, which is where there's nobody there but me. It's only a resupply place. It has every feature I need to, you know, it's hooked to the network, so I have access to all my stuff. And it's got all the various equipment that I need to do whatever I have to do whenever I have it. Now, this came out nice. The way that wall piece touches the roof, that looks good, I think. That came out really nice. Okay, so here's the lobby. Here's the first chunk. Now we're going to move it out of the way to the side, and we're going to build the bottom half. And we're gonna get to the point here where I made a big mistake because I forgot how parts of her thing was built, how her house was built. And remember I said that one piece that was inside by the blanket balcony, it was kind of tucked under the other foundation. Yeah, I forgot about that. I knew there was something to close the gap, but I put it in the wrong place. And that's going to affect how this comes out once I get done screwing around this wall. But this again is a fairly standard thing. Of course, I changed the balcony because for my purposes, I need an open window. And because I'm gonna put the main doctor in here and then like a chem cellar in this little window here. So he's gonna be on the lower level, she's gonna be on the upper level. So as this goes on, we will continue this. I saw today that, or it was either today or yesterday, that the, because today, as I'm recording this, it is Thursday. I noticed the Creation Club has updated, and there is something in there from Eleonora, which is a bunch of Settlement Workshop pieces. Now, I have not seen a review of this. They say, oh, there's like 85 pieces and yada yada. And I looked at the screenshots, and some of the stuff looks really cool. I'm like, okay, this may be the first thing I'm interested in getting, but there's only like, you know, 20, 25 things on the various screenshots. There's no real inventory of it. So now I'm waiting to see if someone reviews it. No one's reviewed it as of the time of this recording. You know, I looked up and see if anybody had gone through it, and there were some people that commented that it did update, but they were mostly fixated on the gun paint, and I'm like I give a crap about that. But if y'all see a review of this, could you do me a favor and leave me a link in the comments so I can go check it out? I mean, I'll keep searching myself. Of course, I'm not, you know, I'm not completely incapable of doing that, but it's nice to have help, I guess. So I put the stairs in first, obviously, because I need the stairs. The stairs are the tricky part. The stairs are what I need to line up on, so I had to make sure those are right first and then make sure everything snaps around them, because stairs are kind of hard to refit when they're not. Okay, and that's something else here. This right there with the roof, when I group selected and it came out. For whatever reason, when you snap a roof onto a wall and you group select the wall, it does not take the roof with it. But if you group select or have something touching the roof that has been group selected, like, okay, so right here, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to fill that gap that I think is here, right? Remember I told you the gap was below this wall? Well, I forgot. So I'm gonna put this here, right? The original structure does not have a piece in this location, and this piece sticks out just enough to where it doesn't like other things touching it when you group select it, and that's gonna come by in a minute. So, so what you can do if you want your roofs to go with you is just put something, group select something next to it that touches it, and it'll go with it. So now I'm going to solve the problem of the angled roof that I don't have access to, and I'm going to do that by using a technique we used in the previous one with the elevated roof, right? Build a set of railings around the floor, group select the roof on top of it, and then stick that on top. And that way I'll have the extra headroom that I need when the elevation changes on the bottom. This part came out really good. It took me a couple of tries to get the angles right and, you know, pick the right place to group select it. But I continue to be really surprised and pleased at how soft the snappable edges of the roofs are. I mean, look how far this goes in. Look how nice that is. It just goes right in. Of course, part of it's the railings too, you know, because the railings they're all pretty soft as well. So now I need to put this thing on here. Now I need to put a ladder up so I can see, blah, blah, blah. So anyway, Creation Club, yeah, if you see anything, let me know. I'll keep looking myself. But this may well be the first thing that I want to get from it. Of course, it's, you know, 200 credits and I've only got 100 in my little balance. So I will wait for it to go on sale if it is something I'm interested in. So what we're gonna do here is instead of an angled roof with a triangular hole in the wall, right? I'm just gonna put this elevated roof on top of this thing. And now I'm trying to find a good angle to where I can see, drop it low enough, and get it to line up on the first try. And then, of course, moving the other thing out of the way. That's why I'm down here in this part of the island, so I can see and so things don't touch each other. Because that's one of the dangers of group selecting when you're doing large things like this. If you get too close to the other thing, you're stuck. You'll have to tear it down and rebuild it to move it. So, yeah. So I'm going to drop this thing in here. I'm going to wedge it in there, see how it works, and where is it going to go? Right about, no, it's gotta go. Now see, on this part here, where I'm getting stuck, where it's getting hung up and turning red, is on the wall on the back. Not the flat wall, but the one that sort of sticks out, the thicker one. That thing's top has like a roof edge on it, and it doesn't really like to play nice with these railings. So you kinda gotta push a little bit inside it. You can't really put it on top of it. But that, the thin walls, it works great. So if you want to do this technique and you want it to look really nice inside, use flat walls all the way around, I think would be the moral of the story here. So, okay, so now I have my building, right? I have not put the other roof on yet because I know if I snap it, it's going to not move. So I'm just gonna leave it alone for now. Now comes the fun part, and this is the worst part about doing this type of building. When you're doing two big groups like things together at the same time, is being able to see where they line up at the point where you want them to touch. Like in this case, I have to be able to see either through the front door, right? I have to be able to see through the front door. Now, am I going to be inside the building when I do it or outside the building when I do it? I don't know. I can't quite figure out which direction is going to be best for my purposes, and I don't know how to line it up. So this is going to be trial and error. So my first instinct, of course, stick the biggest building and stick it on the smallest one, right? Because the smaller part is higher. But of course, once I put this over the opening, I'm not gonna be able to see how to line it up. So I'm like, okay, yeah, that's not gonna work. How about inside? Can I do inside? Yeah, I can, but I can't see on the right now. I can't see where it's gonna line up underneath. I can't check the elevation from this angle, right? So I'm like, okay, how am I gonna do this? Am I picking up the right piece? Do I need to pick up the smaller piece and put it on there? How am I gonna do this? How's this gonna work? Let's see, let's drop this. All right, let's push it down, right? But keep it away. But see, when I do this, right, now I'm thinking I'll get inside this piece and line the other one up on the outside, but I have to be able to jump into it, right? It has to be low enough where I can jump into it, but high enough to where I can lower this low enough on that raised thing. So here we go. Here we go. So here's my mistake. You see that railing on the left is sticking out? That thing will not let me slide this close enough to the deep, to the balcony one, because that piece, the wall piece sticking out, is touching it. I literally did not figure this out until, I don't know, about a half an hour after I finished this. So we're lining it up. I can't see the wall on the right, right? I'm looking at the elevation. I'm like, does this look good? That's about right. Yeah, that'll work. Right there, a little closer, and drop it. You gonna drop it? Not yet. Yeah, looks good. Excellent. And I noticed the gap. And oh my God, look at the size of this gap. This gap is too large. I'm thinking, is that, because my mantra is good enough, right? So I'm thinking, is that good enough? Can I patch that hole? That's a really big hole, man. And then of course the gap between the main house and the small, I can't cover that. And I'm like, no, this is not gonna work. So this part, so now I have to tear it down, right? I have to take down enough of it to where I can group select the rest of it away from the main building without group selecting everything, because I don't want to have to redo that three rail wall. So I save the game, come back here in the daytime, let's start tearing it down. The good thing is rebuilding it will not take that long because I've already built it once. And I'm thinking, okay, is this going to be good enough? Am I far enough away here? Yeah, okay, good. So now I take this little proto wall out and we're gonna go ahead and rebuild the whole thing over here. So I did seriously debate not editing this part out, the rebuilding part, but you know what? Maybe this will help if you run into the same kind of situation, knowing that you don't have to take the whole thing down, you only take part of it down, and that rebuilding is fairly straightforward because you've already built it once, so I already know what it's gonna look like and I already have all the pieces in the workshop. So yeah, while we're doing this, we're gonna rebuild this. Another thing I did not occur to me because I play in survival, right? And when I play in survival, when I sleep, I get sick. So I'm hesitant to save. The pro tip to take away from this is if you try and group two select two big pieces together like this, if you wanna save yourself some rebuilding time, save the game before you try and put them together, okay? I feel so dumb for not having thought of that. It literally never even occurred to me to maybe save it before I try to do something complicated, and that would require me to do a lot of work, or it would take some time to redo. But as you can see, we're just putting this thing back together same way as it was, no big deal. In other news, other things that I've noticed in the game, because of course I've got to put something in here that's like, hey, look at this weird thing in the game. Did y'all know there's a ghoul in the game that has eyes? Not just the black or the white, but who has actual eyes. There's a ghoul in the game who has eyes with a pupil. I mean, the eyes are yellow. It turns out the ghoul that has the eyes, and this freaked me out when I noticed it the other day, because I've never noticed this before, and it's so weird because I've been there 1,000 times, is the ghoul guard outside the third rail in Good Neighbor. The guy standing out in front, he has eyes. He's the only ghoul I've ever seen who has eyes. So that was kind of an interesting discovery, kind of an unsettling. It's kind of unsettling, to be honest with you. I'm used to them having the black, you know, or the faded, or the, you know, whatever, the messed up eyes, not actual eyes. And then, and of course I've noticed I went to Milton Hospital. I've been working down in Jamaica Plain working out of Jamaica Plain in the immersive gameplay playthrough. Because Halen wants me to go to Gunner Plaza to get a flux capacitor, whatever, one of those pieces, right? I'm terrified of gunners. I don't think I'll be able to handle this. So I've been putting it off and putting it off for like 6 levels. I don't want to deal with it. Because I find that being indoors with strong enemies is usually a recipe for death. So I've been putting it off, yada, yada, whatever. And so I, you know, go around, clear out the West Roxbury Station, get my tumblers today, because lockpicking is a little bit more difficult in this mod, and having those magazines helps a ton. So I was rounding those all up. And after I cleared it out, I was going through Milton Hospital just to scavenge, because it's just got lots of good stuff in it. And I ran into that room again, and I just like, it just, as soon as I did, I'm like, oh my God. So one of the things that bothers me more than it probably should is things that are in places that they don't belong. Like, there's no origin point for them. I may have mentioned this before. If I haven't, I apologize. But like Milton Hospital, right? Milton Hospital is the one where you go for the Silver Shroud, right? So, you know, you have to go in through the lobby, you go up the elevator, down the elevator, through the floor, jump through here. And okay, now I remember to save. See, I just remember to save. So now I'm gonna try this again. So while I'm doing that, so I'm going through up, down, whatever, going to the basement, yada, yada, yada. So I go down the last elevator, the service elevator into the basement, and I go in there, and there's a ton of shipping containers in there, you know, like the ones on the backs of trucks, the cargo containers. And I stop and I look, and I'm like, wait a minute, there's only one way into this basement, and it's an elevator. And these cargo containers are like, I don't know, 20 feet long by 8 feet square. I'm like, how? Oh, got a settler. Let's just give him a bed so I can get back to what I was doing. So I'm like, how did these get in here? It stuff like that. And of course, in Fort Strong, same thing. You go to Fort Strong, you go through, and you go down the elevator into the armory part, you know, where they're doing the research and stuff, and they got all the weapons. And you go into the main room where there's all the nukes, and there's a friggin' megaloader in the middle of the basement. I'm like, how'd you even get this in here, dude? It's like, there's no possible, you have to, like, disassemble it to get it in here. And then the room is so small, it can't even move around. I'm like, why, what? So, okay, so here we go. More quirks that I probably think too much about. And see, I'm trying to put this in where I can see where the gap was. See the gap back there? And I'm like, okay, can I get this in? And I'm thinking there's something that's blocking it that I can't see from this angle inside that house. So we're going to have to abandon that. Yeah, you're not going to do it, dude. Now you can't see the lineup in the hole. You've got to go inside to do this. So now we're going to try it the same way I just did. But this time we're going to be small. It's too high. Let's lower it. And so here's the perils of group select, folks. When you're group selecting big things together, big complicated structures together, save the game, get yourself some good sight lines. I mean, in hindsight, in retrospect, if I could do this over, I probably would have built just the things that touch each other and then snapped everything else around it. I wouldn't have done it like this. I mean, this seemed like a good idea at the time, obviously, because I did it, but if I were to have redone this, I would have placed the stairs, the inside railings, the railings underneath, the inside walls, basically everything that touches these two surfaces, these two horizontal surfaces at this angle, and then just snap the rest of it to it. And now I'm remembering, okay, did I get close enough? I still got a gap. And I'm looking down and I'm like, it's that railing. It's that railing. It's in the wrong place. Wish I'd have taken it out. But anyway, it's in there now. It's close enough. We're good. And now we're gonna put the roof on. But the problem is I've got the railings up there and they're touching the other wall. So now this won't snap to the walls, it'll only snap to the roof. So we're gonna have to group select this thing on there too. But this is why we use this is why I enjoy using the thick roofs when I've got multi-layered structures, because it's got such a tall inside edge that it'll cover that hole that you see that's over the wall level from this angle. And oddly enough, again, the roof just behaves. I'm astonished at how well this thing worked. So that's kind of nice. It's kind of a nice little bonus, kind of a nice little consolation prize for having to deal with regroup selecting the entire thing. Oh Lord. See, I stick it down there and line the inside corner up. See if we can get the shadow to line up properly. And that's it. And up we go. And it's not quite lined up on the back, but you know what? It's close enough, right? Good enough. Good enough. Just rotate a little bit. Nope, you went the wrong way, dude. And now it's a little off kilter, right? But that's okay. It seals that gap. And I think what we're doing, I think we're done with this now. Yeah, okay. So now comes the really fun part. Putting this thing in the spot where I want it. Because the spot where I want it is on the top of a hill, right? It's on the top of that little promontory that I was talking about the last time before. I don't even remember. It's been such a long week. Anywho, but yeah, see, I'm underneath it. I cannot see the bottom of it, right? So I go this side, and it slopes down in this direction, too. And I'm like, I still can't see it. The tree's in the way. I'm blocking it. Like, what the hell's going on here? What's blocking it? And you can see through the right, you can see that little bunch of trees right there is touching the back wall. So that's what's holding it up. And of course, I can't see how it fits between the two buildings. So let's grab our obstacles, not too many of them. Let's check to make sure there's no rugs under these junk fences, which I don't think there are. Nope. So, okay, now we've got our thing. And I remember, oh, you need some elevation, dude. You need some elevation. So let's go ahead and put a couple of ladders up here. Come back down, grab the piece that I know works, which is over here on this side. Shack bridge is up, and up we go. So yeah, this is this little settlement here is sort of nearing completion. It's very, very full now. With this building, I've completed pretty much that whole arc on top of the promontory, which is nice. And then for the next time, there's going to be another building down by the workshops and the first settler house, the first farmer house, because I've got an extra farmer now. I changed my mind on having a trading post. I'm not going to have one on this one. Oh, we got a new settler. No? Well, that's the same guy wandering around. But I need to get the new farmer his own little house, and I think I'm gonna grab a raider shack for that, because it's just gonna be one dude, and he's gonna be a little bit elevated. And he's walking around another house. He's like, hey man, it's a house. It's not yours. Get away. The tricky part here is on the right hand side, because that's the highest elevation of the dirt, and I don't want too much dirt sticking up into the house. I want it to be far enough away to where it's. Oh, is this gonna do it? Yeah, it's close enough. No, that's too far back, man. It needs to be further forward. Come on, a little more. And see, there's a certain point where it drops. I haven't figured that part out yet either. But, okay. And this right here is the most nerve-wracking part, because when I set the building down, I know it has to be right. Because if it's not right, I'm going to lose another hour of my life redoing it, undoing it, or just tearing it down and starting over. And so, okay, now the stairway's too short. And it won't snap because the shack bridge sticks out. So will a taller ladder stick? No. Can I get it to come up and wedge? No. The surface of that shack bridge sticks out too much. Ain't gonna work, man. So okay, problem solving time. How am I gonna get an elevation up there that's gonna look nice? Will anything snap to it? Oh, okay. We'll snap a quarter floor to it. And we'll put the small stair there, which now fits because the ground rises up over there. And I just noticed there's a gap underneath the window. So let's go ahead and fill that gap with my favorite double width filling piece, which is this thing here. Since it sticks out, it looks suitably raggedy. And we'll stick it here, raise it up, make sure it touches the ground, get as close as possible, and snap. There we go. So that looks kind of nice. Looking around the back, seeing if there's anything else I need to do back here. Let's see if we can fill that hole up. I don't think we can. This thing's not going to work. I do eventually manage to do it, and in the tour, the final tour, I'll show you that. What I did in a nutshell is I took a junk fence, and I did a junk fence on the bottom, and then I group selected a wooden post into the top to fill the top of the hole. So we're going to give this thing some supports, some railings. I do end up changing this as well. You can see what the final version looks like from the thumbnail, because of course I've got to take a screenshot before I, you know, furnished it. Dinked around with it, added the other furnishings to it. But yeah, there we go. So there's Kessler's house, which is now going to be a dual doctor's office. And I'm going to eat. Okay, so let's walk around this thing. So this is what it looks like. Now we've got the guard post in the front, this main building here next to the player house. It's sort of set back. It's pretty close between these two other buildings. So, you know, bridging the gap with junk fences is not going to be a problem. But we'll go up in here. This is going to be the main entrance, the main office, waiting area, whatever. And then down the stairs, there's going to be a couple beds and a sitting area. And then we're going to have another station here for another dude to sell drugs. That's pretty much what this is going to be. So this is Kessler's house in vanilla with some, oh, that railing. Oh my God, that's such a rookie's. So yeah, if you do this, don't put that railing in there. Or if you do, put it under the foundation for the raised part. And there we go. So there's our third or fourth building from the game, and we're gonna do one more to do the last farmer. And then we will all furnish it and decorate it and do a tour. And we'll wrap this up for the Spectacle Island portion of our program. And there we go. I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.